Hello guys, welcome back to Piping Engineers. Guys, in today's video we will be learning about the piping interview questions. You all would be searching for a job. Some of you may be looking for a job change. And guys, let me tell you, these questions, if you are going for a piping job, they will definitely help you in the interview. So guys, stay tuned in our videos, and for more updates, please like, follow, and subscribe to our channel. So let's begin our today's video and learn about the few piping interview questions that can be asked in your interview. So guys, the first question that can be asked in your interview is, what is the ASME code used for process piping? So the answer for this is, guys, ASME 31.3. So if we talk about ASME process piping, 31.3 is used. But if someone asks you what is the code, ASME code used for power piping, so you will be saying 31.1 is the code that is used for power piping. So moving on to the next question, guys, ASME B16.5 is used for. So you would be saying, you would know that there are different standards for different things. So the question is, which standard does ASME B16 refers to? So if you will be referring to ASME B16.5, what information about which information you will be getting? So the answer is CS flange fittings. So this is 16.5 is for CS flange fittings. If someone asks you about 16.1, so your 16.1 is also for flanges, but it's the standard for gray cast iron flanges. So moving on to next, guys, from which size NBO of pipe is equal to OD of pipe? So if you have seen the schedule table, you would be knowing that your nominal diameter, your nominal bore of pipe is not equal to your OD of pipe. So but from a particular size, your NBO of pipe becomes equal to your OD of pipe. So it starts from your 14-inch size. So from 14-inch pipe size, your NB becomes equal to the OD of pipe. So guys, these are few of the questions that can be asked in your interview, and I want you to go through these to crack any of the interview and get your dream job. So moving on to the next, from which side of pipe will you take a branch connection in gas and steam line? So this is a very important aspect, guys. To from which branch side, you can't take a tapping from any other side of a pipe. So if you want to take a branch connection from your gas or steam line, you'd had to take it from top side. So this is one of the engineering thing that we consider while we take a tapping. Moving on to the next, so vent is provided at. So guys, why vent is provided? Vent is provided is to provided to remove the gases or remove the air while we are doing some testing at the time of commissioning. So where the vent is provided, what is the location of the vent? So vent is always provided at the highest point. It is quite spread at highest point, so there is no entrapment, and while purging is done, everything that is within the pipe can be removed and taken out. Moving on to the next question, guys, where are weldolets and socolets used? So you would be knowing about weldolets, socolets used. So where are they used? So if someone asks you, they are used in butt weld and socket weld connection. So weldolets and socket welds, socolets are used in butt weld and socket weld connection. So let's see and move on to the next question. So what is the function of valves in pipeline? You would have seen there are different valves that are used in your piping industry. So different valve serves different purpose, but if we talk commonly, they serve three purposes. If you want to regulate the flow, our valves are used. If we want to isolate one line from the another, valves are used. If we want that flow should not return from one point to another, again valves are used. So these are primarily three functions that valves serve in any piping industry. Moving on to the next, guys, which valve is not used for regulation of flow? So there is a particular valve that is not recommended for regulation of flow. So what is the answer? Answer for this is gate valve. If you're going for the job of a piping engineer, either in design, either in construction, these questions are very important, and I guess you should be knowing these questions. Moving on to the next, what is the minimum thickness of CS pipe that require analysis to be done as per ASME B13.3? So if you refer this document, ASME B13.3, this thickness has been mentioned, and the thickness is 19 mm. So if the th thickness is greater than 19 mm, it has to be taken care under the stress analysis. So mark my words, guys. What gas is provided? What is provided in gas lines to remove condensate? So you would be knowing, in gas lines there is some moisture that flows away with the gas, and that has to be removed because If it goes to your burner or if it goes to your equipment, it may destroy your equipment or it may harm your equipment. So this moisture or this condensate has to be removed. So it is removed with the help of drip ports. So this is again a very important question. People generally ask, what is a drip port? What is a steam trap? So you should be knowing all these things. Moving on to the next slide, guys. And the first question here is expansion and contraction of pipe due to fluid temperature and change in pressure can be compensated by. So you would be showing, you would be seeing that if there is a high pressure line or if it is a high temperature line, there are things, expansion and contraction of pipes happen due to fluid. So this can be compensated by if you provide compensators in it, if you provide bellows, and if you provide loops. Expansion loops are generally provided so that expansion and contraction of your pipes can be taken care and excessive stresses are not generated, and to safeguard your piping. So all these three things are generally done in considered in design to take care of the expansion and contraction of pipe due to temperature and pressure changes. Moving on to next, guys, which gas is used for purging? So purging is an important step if you are starting a new plant or if you are taking shutdown or again starting the new thing. So we purge the lines to remove unwanted particles. So basically two things are used to used in purging of lines. One is your nitrogen. Again, why nitrogen? Nitrogen is an inert gas. Another is steam. Steam will be your water. So these two things, they are used for purging of gas lines. Moving on to the next. What do you check before erecting of pipes on pipe rack? So this is a question which a fitter or a foreman who is a piping erector may come across, or in a construction engineer may be asked. So what are the things you will be checking? First of all, we will be checking the elevation, after that alignment, next thing is welding. So if all these three things are done and marked okay, so your pipe is ready for the erection. Next, what type of reducer is used at pump suction? So you would be knowing in pump suction we have a different reducer, and in pump discharge we have a different one. So what type of reducer in pump suction? We use eccentric reducer with flat top. So this type of reducer is used at your pump suction. If someone asks you what type of reducer do we use at pump discharge, so we use concentric reducer in pump discharge. So guys, if you want to learn about more about reducers, you may refer another video on pump suction design. So there you would be knowing what is the difference in eccentric and concentric reducers. Moving on to next, what is the guide support? So you would be knowing there are different supports used in piping. So if someone can ask you different types of supports, so you should be aware of different types of supports. So here the question is, what is a guide support? So it allows horizontal movement of pipe. So horizontal movement of pipe is allowed with the help of guide support. Moving, so guys, thank you for watching the video. I hope you would have learned something about piping industry, the few of the questions that can be asked during interview. So guys, for more videos and updates, please like, follow and subscribe to our channel. Thank you guys, thank you for watching the video.